Today I'm sitting here with the director of the docu-series Wu-tang of Mics and Men. Sacha!
That's me.
Thank you for taking the time out to sit down with us.
Thanks for having me.
So for our real audience, just tell us a little bit about you and your projects.
Well, I started out as a music journalist writing about hip hop. I published my own magazines. I did a magazine called Ego Trip. I did a newspaper called Beatdown. I was a music editor at Vibe magazine, wrote for Spin, Rolling Stone, blah, blah, blah. Before that, I was just a kid growing up in New York City, and hip hop was sort of my culture and my identity. And so I've been able to, you know, transition from journalism and books into film and television, and a lot of the projects I've been doing have been rooted in hip hop.
Nice, nice. So tell us about the docuseries.
It's called Of Mics and Men, Wu-Tang of Mics and Men, and I gave it that name because, you know, so often, you know, there's a month, February, for some reason, they put us in this one month and they think that our history is limited to February. Mm-hmm. Wu-Tang is a classic American group, not just a black group. They're an American group, and I wanted to sort of hold their art up there with what people consider a quote-unquote American classic, like Of Mice and Men. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to make a film that was representative of who they are and where they come from. And to me, hip-hop is always a reflection of and a reaction to the environment. Any kind of artistic expression that black folks in America express, a lot of it is a reflection of and a reaction to the environment. And as you know, Wu-Tang is loved around the world by a cross-section of people. And I've always wondered, you know, I grew up in Queens, I grew up, you know, single mother in the hood, same age as these guys. I understand where they're coming from and what they're talking about, but do people really understand what Wu-Tang's talking about? So I wanted to go back to where they're from and really get a sense of the climate and the environment that fostered who they became.
Taking it back to the roots, I'm from New York, from the
All
Bronx.
Right.
New York in the building.
True.
So were there any challenges while working on this docuseries?
Well, there's, you know, a bunch of guys in a group, and so they all have conflicting schedules, they're all very busy, so it was a bit difficult to get with all of them, but I had the idea to get them all in a theater, in a beautiful theater called the St. George Theater in Staten Island, and sort of show them moments from their lives and their careers up on the screen. And just in the body language that you see with all of them sitting together, there's so much information that you get from getting them all together. And getting them all together is not always easy.
Not always easy, right? Everyone has a busy schedule, doing their thing.
Seeds.
Yep.
Business, you know.
Yeah. Are there any surprises that people might find out when they watch it?
I think that, to me, again, the music is very important in this film, but I don't think we've seen black men this open and vulnerable, talking about their experiences and being sensitive. And I think part of it has to do with they were interviewed by someone like them. Mm-hmm. And someone who they might have known has been in the industry as long as they've been in it. And I think that's the most important thing. I mean, we come from these environments that are tough and rough, and sometimes we feel like we have to be tough and rough. And to be at this place 25 years later where they're not only reflecting on their careers, but reflecting on their lives, the honesty that these guys shared with the viewers, with the audience, I think is really powerful. And I think hopefully it'll be an example for other young black men to sort of look at themselves and be able to express the pain in a way that they feel comfortable.
Transparency is key. Nothing mm-hmm. wrong with being transparent. Now, Wu-Tang Clan, they are hip-hop veterans. So do you see their influence in the music that's out today?
I mean, the independent spirit that is thriving now because of the internet is what Wu-Tang was all about. Mm-hmm. They went out there, they did their own thing, they created a buzz, and then they were able to dictate in so many radical ways how their business model was gonna work. No one had ever done a deal in hip-hop where, okay, you can sign the entire group, but they can go and do their own thing. That's never been heard of. And I think it was on the strength of RZA's vision and his desire to stay independent. We found footage of RZA, like the earliest known interview with Wu-Tang. He's being interviewed by a college student in Brooklyn College, and he basically says, I don't want to be a slave. These record labels treat you like you're their son.
That's what all the artists are saying now. You know, a lot of artists are going independent nowadays, and I think that's the main thing, just wanted to have that creative control over your music.
Mm-hmm. So I think that sort of independent spirit, because so many of us in the inner city, we don't have social capital, we don't have resources, we don't necessarily know how to do it. So when they did it, when mm-hmm. RZA did it, when he did it, that was, it took a lot. It took a lot to really put yourself out there, figure out how to get it done. Now, because the internet is a little bit easier, you know, but it's still something that is how Wu-Tang did what they did is an inspiration for this generation for sure.
What do you hope people take away after they see this film? It's premiering tonight, right?
Yep. I hope that people, when they watch this film, they have a deeper understanding of who these 9 or 10 black men are and were. You know, rest in peace to Old Dirty Bastard. I think, again, it's you know, when a young black man gets shot by the police, it's Black Lives Matter. It's a hashtag. It's activism. It's all these things. And we as a people stand up and say something. But America needs to stand up and say something. America needs to say that American boy was murdered, right? And I think that what Wu-Tang represents is a change in, or the potential for change in American society, because these white kids now, and many of them are adults in their 40s, they didn't grow up on Led Zeppelin. They grew up on Wu-Tang. And so when you have a generation of folks who are familiar with Wu-Tang, familiar with their music, and now hopefully more familiar with their story, it creates a conversation. It creates empathy. It creates understanding.